Okay, so this is your add-on for your yoga sequence. So the first video that I send you, you'll always do as your warm-up. And then now we're gonna add on this leg sequence for you. All right, so toes and heels are together. Roll your shoulders down and back. Open your chest, open your heart. And let's begin. Inhale, upward salute. Reach your fingertips up, lengthen. Create space in between your vertebrae. Root your feet down. Exhale, we fold down. You're gonna allow your head, your neck to release. As you forward fold, lift your kneecaps, lift your upper thigh bones. Imagine there's a wall behind your bum and you're pressing your bum into that wall. And now reach your fingertips forward, lengthen your spine. So you're looking forward, try not to crunch in your neck. Pull your belly in, lengthen. Exhale, folding down. From here, you're gonna sweep your arms up into chair pose. Your toes and heels are together in this first set. You're shining your heart, your gaze is lifted. You're sitting your bum back behind you. And now bring your hands, palms to your heart center. Go ahead and fold forward. From here, separating your feet about 6 inches distance apart. You can always take 2 fists, measure in between your feet to see what 6 inches looks like. And now sweep your arms up and you're back in chair pose. Now, becoming very aware of your alignment. You can look down and you can check. Sometimes what happens is the feet turn out, the feet turn in. Make sure that they stay nice and straight. Keep sitting your bum back, spreading your sit bones, shining your heart, your core is active and engaged. Sit your bum back behind you, keep reaching your arms up. Bring your hands, palms to heart center, folding forward. Inhaling your hands to your shins, look forward, lengthen. Exhaling, folding down. And now from here, you're gonna rise up, awkward pose. Sit your bum back. And from here, we're gonna bring the hands, palms to heart center. Press your feet up. And now we're ready to do some squats. So you're going to bring your arms out in front of you like you're hugging a tree and sit your bum back behind you. And then rise up, squeeze at the top. Sit your bum back behind you, squeeze at the top. We're gonna go through 24 of these. So really making sure that as you sit, and as you come back up, you're squeezing, squeeze at the top. And now we're gonna add some arms if you like. So you can bring your arms down and up. Down and up. Palms are facing each other. As you sit back, you wanna make sure that you really feel your sit bones spreading. So we're working those thighs. So the more calories we burn with our legs, the more calories you'll burn even after you finish this workout. Because our legs are our biggest muscle group. Making sure that your breathing is key as well to your routine. Few more. Always remembering that if you need to take a break, take a break. But part of the point is to work so that you feel the burn. If you don't feel the burn, then that means maybe you didn't work quite hard enough. All right, last one. Okay, now from here, we're gonna bring the hands, palms to the hips, and we're gonna do curtsy squats. So we're gonna drop the right knee down at a straight angle as we come up. So you bring the right foot back behind you, drop that knee down. You don't need the knee to hit. You just want to make sure it's going straight. There's a little bit of a pivot that happens with your waist. Keep your core tucked in nice and strong. Keep your spine nice and straight. Keep smiling on your face, okay? Really using your side glutes as we go through this. Keeping the chest open. 12 more. You guys are doing great, I'm sure. Sometimes the hardest part is just showing up, but once you get going, you can stay with it. A few more. Four more to go. Work those side glutes. Three. Two. And last one on this side. Great. Now we're going to switch to the other side. Recenter yourself, and here we go. I hear little crinks and creaks. I hear my knees clicking, my hips clicking. It's pretty normal. So don't be alarmed. Keep pulling your belly in. Stay focused on your posture. Stay focused on your breath. Two more sets of eight. Making sure you're breathing. Squeezing your glutes as you come up. One more set of eight after this. Almost there. Try not to allow your body to collapse down, which sometimes happens when you start to get tired. Make sure that you keep your chest lifted. Four. Three. Two. Last one. All right, one more set to go. So we're gonna bring the hands in front of us. You're gonna squat down and extend. Squat down. Spread your sit bones as you sit and then squeeze your side glute as you raise. Sit. Heart rate is rising, which is great. We're in a nice, slow burning fat zone. Oblique action in there. Making sure that you're sitting your bum back so that your knees aren't coming forward, but rather going back. One more set. Almost there. Your mountain pose. So we're going to do a little leg stretching now. So inhale your arms up. Exhale, folding down. Lengthen. Exhale, fold down. And then you're going to step back into your downward facing dog. Stretch out your arms, stretch out your legs. And now we're going to go into pigeon posture. So inhale your right leg up towards the sky. Sweep your right knee to the outside of your right wrist and extend your left leg back behind you. You're going to walk your hands around to both sides on the floor to help you straighten out your spine. You're going to look over your left shoulder. You want to make sure that your left leg is straight and your left foot is straight. Now, if you feel like you're uncomfortable because your right hip is not quite going down towards the earth, you can take a block or you can even take a towel. Just place it underneath your hip for extra stability. So that option is there for you. We're going to inhale. Puff the chest like a pigeon. Exhale. Come forward. You can come down to your forearms. If that is comfortable for you, you can make a little pillow for your head to rest on. You also have the option of using the block underneath your head if that feels good. And then eventually, you can release all the way down into your sleeping pigeon. Stretch your fingertips forward and just stay here and breathe. into your hips. So our hips carry with them a lot of tension. For some people, there's a lot of injuries, there's a lot of tightness wrapped up inside of our hips. So it's so important to do postures like this to open our hips. And it's so important to stay in the posture past the point of comfortability. So sometimes when we're in a posture like this, it starts to feel uncomfortable and we want to get out. That's the moment when you need to stay in. So finding that place of uncomfortability, sending your breath to it, breathing in, and seeing if you can actually melt down a little bit deeper, breathing out. And now from here, go ahead and stretch your thighs back up. And we're gonna sweep that right leg back behind you. Taking your downward facing dog, hips up towards the sky. Go ahead and inhale your left leg up. Sweep the left knee to the outside of your wrist and extend your right leg back behind you. And again, the same process, we're gonna look over the right shoulder. Check that the right leg is straight, the right foot is straight. Walk your hands around to both sides, puff your chest, inhale. Exhale, start to come forward. Coming down to your forearms, make a little pillow, or releasing your arms all the way out. And just holding here, breathing, trying to square your hips and trying to find length in your spine. You still want to keep your spine lengthened as you relax down here. Breathing in, any tightness, any tension, breathing out. Acknowledging any differences from one side to the other. They're not necessarily wrong or right, they're just different. It's your body. Acknowledge it, become aware of it, and send away any tension with your breath. Carefully rising up. From here, you're gonna turn around, lie down on your back. You can bring your toes and heels together. This is Baddha Konasana. Bring your hands, palms, next to your body. Take a nice little Shavasana here. Breathing in, breathing out. Extend your legs out in front of you. You're going to lift your right leg up, interlace all 10 fingers around the outside of your right knee. Pull your right knee down and out towards your right shoulder, completely avoiding your rib cage. You're looking down the center line of your body and you're trying to keep both shoulders relaxed on the floor. So a lot of times what happens is the opposite shoulder will lift up. You want to rotate that shoulder back down. Inhale, on the exhale, pull a little bit deeper into your hip, pull, pull, change. Release the right leg down and now bring your left leg up. Pull the left knee down and out towards the left shoulder, completely avoiding your rib cage. Inhale, on the exhale, pull a little bit deeper. Looking down the center line of your body, getting both shoulders relaxed on the floor. Massaging your descending colon as well. This posture is also great for digestion or indigestion if you're ever feeling a little bit queasy or unwell or like you have gas. It's like a great posture that you can take. Left leg down and now go ahead and bring both legs up. Squeezing your knees in. You're gonna grab opposite elbows, squeeze your knees in and roll your hips down. You want your feet to be together, side by side, nice and relaxed. Squeezing your knees in, rolling your hips down, getting a nice tight grip. Sometimes we have to readjust that grip. Squeeze your knees in, roll your hips down, trying to get your spine one day coccyx to neck flat on the floor, looking down the center line of your body. Give yourself a nice tight cuddle. Change, releasing into your Shavasana. Heels touch, toes fall out. Focus on your breath, inhaling. And exhaling. Rolling onto the one side. Sitting back up in your Sukhasana in your happy seat. Beautiful job. Namaste.